How's it going today, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having a great day so far. So what we're going to be talking about in this video today is the differences between a 401k and a Roth IRA. And this is a very important topic, and it's one of these things, it's these lessons that you're just not learning in school or learning anywhere else. And it's extremely important to understand the differences between these two different types of retirement accounts out there. And the other thing I want to point out here as well is people often think that it's one or the other. You can either have a 401k or you can have a Roth IRA, and that is just not the case. And in fact, the best strategy in most cases is to be taking advantage of both a 401k and a Roth IRA. And I'm going to show you guys exactly what that strategy looks like at the end of this video. But starting off here, let's talk about the first difference between these two investment vehicles. Number one, a 401k is sponsored by your employer. So you have to be employed in order to be eligible for a 401k. So myself personally, since I'm self-employed, my company is one person, so I don't have a retirement plan. And so I am not eligible to have a 401k unless I set one up for my company. And in the past, when I did work a job, when I worked for the utility company, I did have a 401k available to me. And the one thing here that's important to understand is it's not mandatory. It's optional whether or not you want to opt in to that employer 401k. Now, the Roth IRA, on the other hand, is independent. It's something you go out there and you set this thing up on your own. It has nothing to do with your employer, and as long as you're within certain income limits, anybody out there can open up a Roth IRA. Second of all, with the 401k, this is one of the biggest issues with them, is that you're limited to the employer plan, and 401ks are not all created equally. There are some 401ks that are really good. They have great selections for ETFs or funds, and they're low in expenses. And there are other 401ks out there that are full of high fee investments that are just not really a good pick for most people. And the issue is, if your employer offers a bad plan, you're pretty much stuck with choosing something from that plan. The benefit to a Roth IRA is that you can go through any firm or brokerage that offers them, and with a self-directed Roth IRA, you can put anything in there. If you want to put stocks in there, if you want to put, you know, the Vanguard 500 fund, whatever you want to put in there, you choose what goes into that retirement account, and you are tax sheltered with that investment. The next difference is with your contributions. When it comes to your 401k, you are putting away your pre-tax income. So before you have a chance to even touch that money, it comes out of your paycheck off of your pre-tax income. With a Roth IRA, you're putting away your post-tax income. And a lot of people say, well, you know, that's a huge disadvantage, but it's actually not when you consider the tax implications of each of these two investment vehicles. The next difference is a big pro for the 401k. It's an incentive that some companies are offering, and it's called a company match. We'll go over an example of what that looks like in a little bit. But with a 401k, some employers out there offer a match to incentivize people to contribute towards their retirement savings. So in my case, when I worked for that utility company, they would match my contributions, you know, 50 cents out of every dollar up to 6%. So if I contributed 6% to my retirement, they would contribute 3%. But if I did anything more than that, they would contribute no more than, you know, 3% of my annual salary as a bonus. So with the 401k, if your company offers a company match, you have this possibility here to take advantage of completely free money being offered by your employer. The downside to the Roth IRA, there's no match out there. The government's not gonna match your money. Nobody's gonna give you extra money to reward you for using the Roth IRA. So there are no incentives like that. As far as the 401k goes, there are no income limits as far as how much money you're making. You could make $500,000 per year and still contribute to a 401k. Now, a Roth IRA, on the other hand, there are income limitations where you can't make more than this amount of money. And for single filers in 2019, that's $137,000. And for married, that is $203,000. So if you make over that amount of money, you can't contribute to a Roth IRA. The next difference is the amount you can contribute each year. With the 401k, for the updated numbers for 2019, you can contribute up to $19,000 per year of your pre-tax income. And the Roth IRA, on the other hand, it's $6,000 per year or $7,000 per year if you're 50 or up in what they call a catch-up period where you can do more contributions per year. Now let's talk about the interesting part here, which is the tax benefits here, all right? With the 401k, there is a tax benefit because you're able to reduce your taxable income, and based on what tax bracket you fall into, it may be advantageous to contribute extra money into your 401k to push yourself down a different bracket. So that is one of the games people play here with the 401k, is ramping up their contributions to fall under a certain tax bracket, you know, to save money by falling into a different bracket entirely. There are no tax benefits with the Roth IRA, but there is a major difference in how you are taxed with both of these investments. With the 401k, you're paying taxes later on the growth of that money. So you don't pay taxes going in, but you pay taxes once you start to take money out of that account and redeem that money. With the Roth IRA, you're paying taxes now. You're contributing with post-tax income, but as a result, your money is growing tax-free. And that can be a huge benefit, especially for young people, is having decades of growth and compounding within a Roth IRA without ever having to pay taxes, as long as they wait until, you know, 59 and a half years old to begin withdrawing from that account. Now, another huge difference between these two accounts comes down to penalties if you decide to take money out of these accounts. If you dip into a 401k early, you're going to get a huge slap on the wrist, and it's going to be painful. You're going to pay all of the taxes on all of those contributions plus a 10% penalty. So it is not something I would ever recommend doing, cashing out a 401k early. I know people that have had to do this for one reason or another, and it results in a nasty tax bill at the end of the year. The advantage to the Roth IRA is that you can withdraw your contributions at any point in time, since you already paid taxes on that money, and you don't have to pay any taxes or withdrawal penalties because it's money that you've already paid taxes on. So that is one of the benefits to the Roth IRA, is that if you put money in there and down the road you need that money, you can pull out your contributions anytime. But if you pull out any of the money up from the growth of the account, that is when you're going to pay taxes plus that 10% penalty. So in a nutshell, any money you put into your 401k, you pretty much can't take it out except for specific use cases. So if you do think you're going to need that money, don't put it in your 401k, maybe put it in your Roth IRA, that way it can grow, and down the road you can pull that money out and pull out your contributions without paying any kind of taxes or penalties. And then finally, one of the biggest differences here, in my opinion, with the 401k versus the Roth IRA, is that it's kind of a hedge against future tax hikes. So basically, the way tax laws are written right now, with the Roth IRA, since you've paid taxes already and you use taxable income, you're not going to pay taxes in the future. With the 401k, you haven't paid taxes on this, so down the road, you are going to pay taxes. And this comes down to a question of, do you think taxes are going to be higher in the future, the same, or lower? If you think taxes are going to be lower in the future, then a 401k probably makes more sense because you can take advantage of that lower future tax rate. If you think they're going to be the same, there's no real difference here. But if you think that taxes might be higher based on our national debt and all the different problems we have with Social Security, you know, personally, I believe taxes will be higher in the future. You can hedge against future taxes by paying taxes now and not having to pay them later through the Roth IRA. Now, yes, they could change these tax laws, but the way it stands right now, you can lock in a lower tax rate today by using a Roth IRA instead of going through a 401k. Now, as I said earlier in this video, in most cases, it makes sense to use both the 401k and the Roth IRA, and I'm gonna show you guys exactly why that is right now. So this is the basic strategy here that makes sense for most people, assuming that you don't know what you're looking at in terms of your 401k. If you have no idea if your employer's plan is a high fee or a low fee plan, this in most cases is the best option, but I would always recommend going out and talking to a financial advisor, you know, if you have any questions on this, because making the wrong decisions across your entire life could cost you a significant amount of money. But anyways, number one, the first thing that makes sense in most cases is always maximize employer match. This is literally free money being offered to you. A lot of people aren't taking advantage of it, and so you need to take advantage of that free money that your employer is offering through the employer-sponsored contribution or match. So like I said, in my case, at my old job, I made about $60,000 per year. I contributed 6% of my pay, or $3,600, to my 401k, and my company matched me 50 cents on the dollar, up to 3%. So that 3% earned me an extra $1,800 per year of completely free money going into my 401k. So that is usually the best thing to do, is maximize up until what your employer is going to match. Number two, the second step is to maximize to a fee-free or a low-fee Roth IRA. And I'm gonna go through two examples with you guys at the end of this video to help you understand the differences and why you might actually want a low-fee versus a fee-free Roth IRA. And then third and finally, that is when you would put surplus money into your savings account for any kind of major life purchases, for maybe your emergency fund. And then eventually, if you have more money to invest, that is when you would put that money in a taxable account where you're going to be paying capital gains taxes. A lot of people make the mistake of skipping step number two entirely. They contribute to their 401k, but then they open up a taxable account instead of a Roth IRA, and they're paying taxes on their gains for pretty much absolutely no reason. Now, let's go ahead and talk about opening a Roth IRA. If it's something you're interested in doing, I have been studying different brokerage accounts and investing accounts for a couple of years now, and I have a lot of good insight on some of these different platforms. Now, I am affiliated with both M1 Finance and Betterment, and I do have links in the description. So if you use those links, I do get a kickback or a commission. I just wanna be transparent about that, but you guys absolutely do not have to use those links if you don't want to. It certainly does help me out though, and supports my channel and allows me to make more videos like this. But starting off with the fee-free Roth IRA, based on all the options I've looked at, I have found that M1 Finance has basically the best offerings out there for the free platforms. You can pick individual stocks, you can put your money into ETFs, or you can go and invest in some of their expert pies, and they're all fee-free. You're not paying any expenses to M1 Finance. And in those expert pies, they offer what's called a TDF, or a target date fund, where you basically put in your target retirement date and they're going to give you specific investment plans, you know, tailored towards that retirement date. And that is something that is not being offered by any other free investing platform out there. Second of all, you're paying nothing to M1 Finance. You may pay an expense ratio to the ETFs you invest in, but you're going to be paying those regardless of what brokerage account you go through. And ultimately, this means that you're keeping more of your money invested and ultimately allowing your money to grow rather than paying money in unnecessary fees. And then third of all, the reason why I like M1 Finance is they have a low minimum of just $500. And so that is pretty accessible for most people. So that is, in my opinion, a good free investing platform. And like I said, there is a link in the description if you want to watch my full review video on M1 Finance or open up an account with them. Now, option number two for Roth IRAs is opening up a low-fee Roth IRA. And in my opinion, I think Betterment is a very solid choice for this. Now, Betterment is offering basically portfolio guidance, or like I like to say, peace of mind, for 0.25% expense ratio. And the benefit to Betterment is that this is going to be tailored to your goals or your specific needs. So you'll put right in there, you know, this is what my goal is, this is when I want to retire, and the algorithm will build you a custom portfolio based on those needs. The downside to going through a free option like M1 Finance is that those expert portfolios are not tailored to any one specific person. And so you may find that you get a better built portfolio by going through a service like Betterment. And it's a good option aside from going to an in-person financial advisor where you may pay, you know, a 1% annual fee or more. Another benefit to going with a low fee option like Betterment is that they are going to automatically rebalance your portfolio and reallocate your portfolio. So one of the downsides to going through a free option is that you're going to have to remember to rebalance that portfolio if your allocations get out of whack. And you're gonna also have to remember to change your allocations because you may not wanna have all this risk involved with your portfolio as you get older. So if you're a portfolio junkie and you like investing and you wanna be an active investor, you know, you can take advantage of that cost savings by using a free platform like M1 Finance. But if you don't know what you're doing and you don't wanna remember to rebalance your portfolio or reallocate it, that is kind of the niche here that Betterment is filling. And that's at a very reasonable annual fee here of 0.25%. And then the other benefit they offer here is a tax coordinated portfolio. So basically what they're doing is they're taking all of your different investing portfolios and essentially looking at what you're investing in and your holdings. And they take any investments that you're going to pay higher taxes in and they move those into your Roth IRA where you're going to be tax sheltered. Now the benefit to this is there is some tax savings and they have found that on average it boosts your after-tax return by 0.48% per year. So when they're charging you 0.25% but this benefits you 0.48, it essentially pays for itself if you take advantage of that tax coordinated portfolio. And then finally, another reason why I like Betterment is they have a $0 minimum to open up a Roth IRA with them. But anyways, guys, that is the difference between a 401k and a Roth IRA. And then there's a couple of options there if you're looking to open up a Roth IRA yourself. I will link up to all of these resources in the description below. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one.